Family and friends will gather here today as witness to the love and commitment between Jeffrey and Kara Lee. We're here to support their decision to be married as well as to pledge our support to them by providing encouragement, example, and friendship in hopes of strengthening an ever-growing love that they share. We're here to witness vows and exchanging of rings. We're here to honor the union between two people. We're here to celebrate the journey of love between Jeffrey and Kara Lee. We're also here for cake. Guys, the ceremony is about proclaiming your love to each other by sharing your commitment to each other, to God, and your family and friends. Let's all pray. Father in heaven, as we're gathered here today, we stand in awe of you and who you are and what you've done to bring us together. Father, two families are joined together because of the love that Jeffrey and Kara Lee have for one another. We call on you to be the center of this union, for you to bless their relationship with one another and with each of their families as they make this journey. Now we ask for your presence to be with us as we honor the two becoming one. Thank you, Father, for your constant care and everlasting love. Amen. Peace be with you.
Let me not, to the marriage of true minds, admit impediments. Love is not love which alters when it alteration finds, or bends with the remover to remove. Oh no, it is an ever-fixed mark that looks on tempests and is never shaken. It is a star to every wandering bark whose worth unknown, although his height be taken. Love is not time's fool, though rosy lips and cheeks within his bending sickle's compass come. Love alters not with his brief hours and weeks, but bears it out, even to the edge of doom. If this be error, and upon me proved, I never writ, nor no man ever loved.
If I speak in the tongues of men or of angels, but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship that I might boast, but I do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now we see only a reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
The joy we feel now is a solemn joy because marriage has consequences, both social and personal. Marriage requires love, as we read about it, but it's a word that's often used with vagueness and sentimentality. We may assume that love is some kind of rare mystical event, when in fact it should just be our natural state of being. The Beatles said it best: love is all you need. This is true, but we're not talking about gooey, sentiment love. We're talking about the fullest extent of love, self-sacrificing love. You heard about it. What does it look like? Love means putting up with each other. It means dealing with each other's faults, having patience when he doesn't do it the way you want him to, or when it takes her forever to get ready. Love means being nice to each other. You know, that may sound like a given, but some days it's harder to do than others. Love's a nice compliment about the way she looks, holding the door open, sending flowers. Love's leaving him a sweet note at his lunch, or doing his chore, or giving him a kind word. Love doesn't resent the other person. Rejoice in each other's successes. Build each other up, because marriage is not about a competition. Love says, I'm not jealous about your accomplishments. Love also doesn't love accomplishments in the other person's face. Love doesn't say, I told you so. Love is not arrogant. Love is being polite and saying please and thank you instead of hey yous or It takes turns with TV control. Take a turn making dinner and doing the laundry. Love's about looking out for the best interest of the other person. It's not all about me anymore. Love fulfills the other person. Love is holding your temper. It's not letting those little quirks or irritating habits bother you. It's overlooking the raised toilet seat or a nagging reminder. Love does not hold grudges. We are not made to hold on to hatred or bitterness, especially for our spouses. Love just doesn't keep a score. Love doesn't wish any ill will or mean feelings towards your spouse. Love is genuine and it's authentic. Love takes care of every person's safety and well-being. Love means having faith in each other, trusting that the other person is always looking out for you. Love looks forward to a future together. Love means sticking together no matter what. Love is a commitment. So death can part. We'll get to that later. Love is never letting each other down. Vows are a verbal expression of love. It's a commitment that you share. Paul's writing here a great description of the concept of love. Paul, although he was a bachelor, understood what it took to make a good marriage, because he understood it, because he grasped the love of Christ, as well as the love we have for one another. In Ephesians, he writes, submit to one another out of reverence for Christ. Now, submission is not a popular concept in today's society. It carries a connotation of just letting someone else control you, or boss you around. In a marriage relationship, you voluntarily humble yourselves to each other because you love. You love each other. We see this acted out in the vows of marriage. Paul continues, wives, submit to your husbands as you do to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as Christ is the head of the church, his body, of which he is the Savior. Now as the church submits to Christ, so also wives should submit to their husbands in everything. But husbands, love your wives, just as Christ loved the church and gave himself up for her, to make her holy, cleansing her by the washing of water through the word, in and to present her to himself as a radiant church, without stain or wrinkle or any other blemish, holy and blameless. In this same way, husbands ought to love their wives as their own wives. He who loves his wife loves himself. After all, no one ever hated their own bodies, but they feed and care for their body, just as Christ does for the church, for we're members of his body. And for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. This is a profound mystery, but I'm talking about Christ and the church. However, each one of you must also love his wife as he loves himself, and the wife must respect her husband. Jeffrey, will you grab your hand? Now, Jeffrey, will you repeat after me? I, Jeffrey. Affirm my love to you, Carolyn.
Affirm my love for you, Carolyn.
As I humble myself to you.
As I humble myself to you.
I promise always to respect your needs.
I promise to always respect your needs. I will endeavor through kindness.
Unselfishness and trust.
To achieve a warm, rich life.
We now look forward to it. I
take you as my wife.
To have and to hold. For better and for worse. For richer and for poorer. In sickness and in health.
While we both shall.
Carolee, repeat after me. I, Carolee. Affirm my love to you, Jeffrey.
Affirm my love to you, Jeffrey.
As I humble myself to you.
As I humble myself to you.
I promise always to respect your needs.
I promise always to respect your needs. I will endeavor through kindness.
Unselfishness and trust.
To achieve the warm, rich life. We now look forward to it. I take you as my husband.
To have and to hold.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
While we both shall live. And you both have some words to share with each other.
I'll begin. My Cara, my bride, from the day I met you, I was sleeping. Your smile, your beauty, your articulate words, your mannerisms, a southern belle. I was in awe and I was going to live. Now today, in the presence of friends, family, and God, I vow to you a lifetime of unconditional love and commitment. I vow to be open, patient, and kind, to love you during our best and worst times, to appreciate and respect you by my words and actions, and most importantly, to keep God, the author of marriage, and this church, the foundation of our love and family, to be the man God willed, with you by my side forever. Till death do us part, you are my joy.
Jeffrey, I vow to love you and to encourage you, to submit to you and to put your needs ahead of my own, and to cherish you as my beloved husband. I pledge to you my honesty, my fidelity, my patience, and my forgiveness. I will do my best to protect you and comfort you. I will strive to be the wife that God intends for me to be. I love your caring ways, your gentleness, your laugh, your joy, your integrity, and your commitment to God. I love you, and I look forward to a beautiful life with you.
And now these three remain: faith, Jeffrey and Carolyn, the pursuit of such unity we just described is motivated by your love for one another. Before you exchange rings, I want to talk about love and what God desires for us to share. What God desires and what the world often shares with us are complete contrasts. Our world cheapens the concept of love every time we turn on a television or look at a magazine. I encourage you to pursue love at a deeper, more mature, eternal level. What drives your love must be something far beyond superficial qualities. If I ask you today to answer the question, why do you love this person? You might be tempted to offer a common answer, like, she's beautiful, or he's handsome, or she's smart, he's funny, caring, she sings well, he has a cool beard. You know, I'd say to you those answers, while honest and true, fall short of reality. Because if those are the only qualities, your final answer, possibility does exist for someone else to come between the two. For like it or not, there may be somebody out there that's pretty, but it seems better, or that has a better beard. Instead, I encourage you to resist the temptation to give a quick and easy answer to the question of why you love each other. Some words cheapen what's real between the two of you. Cling to the mystery of one another. The fact that there's no one else who can replace this person in your life, no matter how beautiful, intelligent, smart, funny. There's no one who shared the same experiences, the same journey that you shared. These experiences are only going to grow from this day forward as you walk beside each other. Your love must be irreplaceable. This love will now be symbolized by the exchanging of rings. Just as a ring, a circle has no ending. May your love and may your journey have no end. So I pray you have no end. Take Carolee's hand and the ring on her finger. And repeat these words which reflect your covenant together. Carolee. I love you with all that is me.
I love you with all that is me.
I pledge to you. In front of God and in front of friends and family. Wherever life leads us. Whether in joy or heartache. I will never leave your side. I will never cease to love you.
Wherever life leads us.
Whether in joy or heartache. I will never leave your side. I will never cease to love you. As long as it sticks, it's good.
Thank you.
made your vows before your friends and family, made your vows before God, publicly exchanged rings, symbolically joined to the unity candle. Man and wife, now it's time to kiss your bride. Now may the love that has brought you together continue to grow and enrich your lives. May you meet with courage the problems that arise to challenge you. And may your relationship always be one of love and trust. May the happiness you share today be with you always. And may every word you've pledged here be a living truth in your lives. Ladies and gentlemen, I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jeffrey Sidney. Thank you.
Thank you.